All right, what is going on, my lovely ladies and gentlemen of the world? We are here with another version of Replay Theater. As always, timestamps below if you want to skip all this bullshit I'm about to do right now. You'll find all the matches down there. You will also find a playlist of all past, present, and future Replay Theaters in the description as well. I just wanted to bitch a bit. You cannot come over here and just be like, oh, these are the top-ranked motherfuckers in the world. Let me grab their replays. You can't do that. Also, Porto Picho putting in work. Look at that shit. Three characters that don't even have number rankings. Maybe even more, potentially. Those are just his top three. Can you actually see whether or not, like, okay, I forgot. Whatever, fuck it. It said to press either square or triangle. And I forgot that with this beautiful new stick I am utilizing, square is cancel and circle. Well, basically, circle and square are swapped. So I pressed square and it canceled instead. But anyway, just figured maybe you would want to see my process. It's literally all I do. Just in case you were curious. Look at that. There's a level 31 person. They're playing an Amane. That's interesting to me. You don't see Amane very much. This person, we down with them. But most of the time, if we see below level 30s, we don't really give a shit unless there are characters or people involved that we do indeed give a shit about. That's all I do. I just sit here and I just roll through stuff. I actually cannot. I should have checked. I cannot remember. When? Versus level 22, whatever. It's like right here. We don't give a shit about either of these characters. Neither Hazuma nor Lychee. But they got a word in their ranking. Thus, we take them. Oh, I wonder if. Actually, I did want to check this out. I wonder if this is the real Goichi. 92% win rate. That's a decent indicator that it very well might be. Oh, this one doesn't even matter. This one isn't going to work. I don't understand why people continually upload their replays. So this is, I don't know if this is actual V-Gact, who I remember, or maybe I'm remembering the name improperly, but I believe this dude, Gact, probably still is, a very, very good Sin player in Guilty Gear. Used to be the Sin player that I looked at if I ever wanted to try and, you know, find some good Sin matches. And so once I saw that, it brought that back again. I don't know if I'm remembering correctly or not. But I don't understand why. Like, this dude keeps on uploading replays. Same with a player named Sadie, who used to be a very good Tager player. Is still a pretty good Tager player, but they switched to Izanami. And I would say they're probably one of the best Izanamis in the world right now. They also upload a shit ton of their replays. But they have it set so that you actually cannot view them. So, like, once I go over and check, you're going to see it's going to say you cannot watch this replay. Oh, is this one? Well, no, because I feel like I remember. Let me just go check. I mean, this will just be the end of this because I don't want to sit here for 20 minutes and just do that shit. But I feel like that Otter one with the bang I've already gotten. But maybe I'm remembering incorrectly. I thought I had seen a bang. No, now we're too far down. Oh, yeah, see, I downloaded the same one twice. But see, wait, what? Oh, that's fucking weird. So I wonder. Actually, I don't know. I don't know. God damn it. Ah! Yeah, see, Gag Star. Now I don't get to do that. So how do I delete these now? Oh, that's, yeah, so I have to press. I need to remember. I'm not pressing square to delete. Ugh. This is the worst. You know, I'll go through this later because I'm going to go down here first anyway. Because I know all of these. I go through them beforehand now. After I download all of them, I go through them all to see if it tells me you cannot play back this, and then I'll just delete them so you don't see it anymore. I can do that after all of this. Oh, fuck me. Okay, good. I have to press a button. Oh, wait, shit. We don't want this. We don't want display. There we go. Perfect. Perfect. Fucking slide move, man. I legitimately feel like against a very large portion of people that are stupid, i.e. me, you could legitimately beat them with Izanami by just doing super jump backwards, float, then do that slide bullshit. I don't think I've ever not been hit by it if I'm on the ground. Because you just don't expect, like, when they're in the upper left side of the screen for them to just be able to come in and suddenly hit you with a low. But that's exactly what happens. It's incredibly unsafe, and so if you do block it, you're gonna fuck them up for it, but is something that natively anybody that plays fighting games will never expect to happen. I really should learn if there's a gap in between that string that she does where, like, so I think she can cancel it into a low or a high, right? Off of, like, I think, I do not believe she can just do her overhead normally. It has to be initiated by hitting whatever that button is first, and then she can either do an overhead or a low off of it. I wonder if there's a gap in there that I can reversal through. Were I using a character that has a reversal? Oh, they fucked up. Oh, no. Very clearly, they can do it raw. But in terms of that block string where they do throw the overhead in, they pretty much always do something afterwards, and it does kind of look like, in general, when Arc System Works does something like that, they put a gap in there where it's not like a true block string. You're not in blocks 100% of the time. And so usually you can do something, especially if the move that follows is safe. And that move is safe. Speaking of just randomly spamming shit. Hi, Mai! How are you doing? No, fatal down. I don't think I've seen this combo before. That's pretty sick. Oh, no, nope, totally fucked it up. They probably would have been able to extend that to what? Somewhere around 4,500, if I understand that character in any sort of capacity. And that is a lot of damage to just give away, especially against an Izanami. You never want to. I mean, this is what happens. This is kind of what BlazBlue has become in general. I mean, honestly, it's kind of what Guilty Gear is as well. Yeah, see, there's really nothing you can even do about that. That's something I should probably test, actually. To see whether or not Exceed Excel goes through the armor. No, it doesn't. You guys even told me. It's only unblockables and throws. Distortions don't give a shit. But like most forms of armor, there is either a... It'll only absorb X amount of hits. Oh, they should be dead. Oh, you fucked up! You fucked up again? Now she's dead, and she didn't burst? That's what happens. Oh, everybody's fucking up. That was bad. That was way... There was no way that was actually gonna work. Well then, just swing for the hills. But yeah, so only, I need to figure out if there is some way that I can make these buttons proper so that it, for whatever reason, it doesn't have them swapped, because it is irritating the hell out of me to have to think every single time I press a button. I don't want to think. I'm not good at thinking. What was I going to talk about before this? I can't even remember. Fuck it. Oh, right, Izanami's armor. So just armor in general is what I was getting at. Pretty much all of them kind of have a threshold. Like, maybe they'll only absorb... Oh, you're gonna get fucked for that? That's interesting. That usually got... Oh, you're fucked. Never mind, that was a bad combo. It'll only absorb X amount of hits, or it'll only absorb X amount of damage. Holy shit, that does work! The first Tager I've ever seen go for that combo route and have it actually work, and then it only did 3,600. Did you just try to do command grab against a jumping opponent? Oh boy. Bullet! The best combo she gets off of that particular hit confirm. What? Bullet! Okay, that was just a fuck up. He actually should. Ooh, excuse me. He should have killed off of that. Because they were in overdrive, if that had been a correct confirm, which all they needed to do was just do the follow-up to the ground pound and probably just throw a 6A in there, and that likely would have been enough damage right there. Bullet! Best combo! Oh, oh no, we didn't get to see it. He decided to burst a 1400 damage combo. Let's see if they get the full thing. They did! That sucks. Now you're in the corner. Shouldn't have done that. Why? Like, out of all the potential options. So if you're gonna go for that, if you're gonna go for wake up something, why wouldn't you just use her DP? It has a better hitbox to it. It's fucking. Oh, you know what? Also? Yeah. Oh shit, I didn't want to do that. So yeah, my fast forward buttons are switched as well. Because all of the, like, the shoulder buttons and the triggers. Well, I mean, I'm talking about this, like, normally. Normally, I just use my regular controller whenever I do this. I don't use the stick. I just happen to be doing this after I did the training mode stuff. And so I still have the stick working. So I guess it's really all this bitching is kind of irrelevant. Why don't you go for that? Well, that worked out. Did I just see a bullet perfect a Tager? Hot! That should never happen. I don't know. Changes the bullet just hurt. Like, every time I watch her get played, it just hurts me. He destroyed her. Like, it's kind of funny how it feels like every single time they make a character great, it's an accident. But goddamn, his arc system works good at utterly destroying characters. I mean, it's not as severe with Bullet, because Bullet was always in a very tenuous position. And it was very easy for her to be shit. But, like, taking a character like Rachel, who was broken as hell, and then turning her into the worst character in the game in the next iteration, that's some fucking talent right there. That was an interesting choice. Because I don't think those little burst things are safe, are they? I mean, they can't because they have invincibility to them. And that's generally the rule. Like, if something has invincibility to it, it's unsafe. What an air grab! God, that looks stupid. Like, legitimately, she was an entire character length above him and just snatched her right out of the air. Grabbed her by the tip of her heel. That's what happens when you try to dress up. Can't dress up in a fight. Oh. I wonder if that 6B was a mistake. Because if he had picked a faster move, he probably would have been able to whiff punish that. Oh my god. Air throws. If only Tager's 360C hitbox was that generous. What? We still might have been able to confirm. Like, if he had maybe, like, jump canceled Rekkas or something, he might have been able to confirm that. Too easy. Oh my god, why would you reset an overdrive combo when she was dead, son? Oh, you are just handing this away on the most generous of silver platters. Now he doesn't have overdrive. He doesn't have a weak point anymore. He's gonna lose. He lost. He should have lost. What the hell? The chokes all around. God damn it. Alright, hang on, I believe I actually can just hit this. Just turn the controller on and it'll fucking work. Yeah, there we go. Perfect, perfect. Oh god, this is so much better. I wonder actually if, like, well, who cares right now? We're doing replays. We don't care about anything else. I wonder If I had had the patience. It's always it's that butterfly effect. The butterfly effect thing. Because I played Bangin' CT very, very poorly. I basically just mashed on armor. That was the extent of my Bang gameplay. But I wonder if I had stuck with him and been as dedicated with him as I was with Tager, how much different I would be as a fighting game player. Gotta use all the calculus and physics knowledge I have built up that I'm never gonna use in the realm of computer science, so I gotta use it somewhere. I think every single one of my computer science professors as well, those beautiful people, just building us up and making sure we're never questioning life and hating everything. I honestly cannot remember a single professor that I had for computer science that wasn't like, I don't get why they make you guys learn as much calculus and physics as they do, because you're never going to use it. It's like, great. The hardest classes we take. Or maybe not necessarily the hardest, but definitely like the ones that require the most work, the most amount of time investment. Useless. They are fun. I should preface it with that. But yeah, so use all that knowledge I have gained. Get into theoretical physics, create something that allows me to breach dimensions, and go into different universes that have branched out in a different path, and find the one where it's basically me, still pretty much the same person. Everything has happened almost exactly the same, except Nate Aristotis stuck with Bang instead of picking Tager. Would he be happier? Would he be having significantly more female relations? Because Bang is a far sexier man than Tager is? Who knows? I mean, we all know, if you're a Bang player, you get all the ladies. Because if there's one game that draws in all the female attention, it's BlazBlue. That being said, I actually do think I see more women at like anime game stuff than I do at Street Fighter stuff. Definitely more than Marvel. There was only one that I ever saw. No, two actually. There were two. Almost forgot about one of them. Maybe if you just went to an anime convention and put on like a come see me, all the ladies would see yourself beating everybody's ass and be like, oh my god, he's so talented! And they would all want you. Do it. Report back. In extreme detail. I want to hear everything. I really don't. Please don't tell me. Also, do you like damn? Oh, if he had meter to rapid cancel that, and he had killed off of it, I would have lost my shit. That would have been godlike. I was gonna say, do you like how much I've been focusing on these matches? What? God, people that just don't tech are like, oops, I hit a button. The bane of my existence. They just hurt me. There's no reason for that to have happened. Just giving it away? So good. Just being able to fling George at you and they stick you in block stun from all the way across the screen and they then have the time to run all the way in and put you in pressure. That's just such an incredible thing to have. He died from that! Holy shit! That's why you don't care about the no-tech. You're just going to come around and get a perfect. It's like, I want to make him feel good about himself before I utterly destroy his soul. No problem. The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel, one. Action. Oh. Oh yeah, but she's default Izzy, you weren't doing any damage off of that, but now you're fucked. You lost. Wait, why did I think... Why did I always think her teleports cost her stocks? Because they very clearly didn't right there. Oh, shit. Izzy, like... I can't believe she didn't change modes right there yet. But that would have been an absolutely perfect time to change modes before they got that last stock. And obviously, Isikor doesn't need all of those stocks. She's dead right here. Nine's dead. Never mind. She should have, right? People that know more about Izioi than I do, she should have been dead. Because he had meter. But like with all those stocks, there had to have been a way for Izioi to bring 9 back down and then go into the super or confirm into something else from there. That there was no way that was the end of the combo. Not a good overdrive. Oh, that's interesting. That didn't confirm, but he still got hit. He really just does not get damage anymore. Oh, nice! This should be damage. That was nice. I like that combo. I think he could have gotten a bit better. But I'm talking in the realm of like 200 to 300 damage, maybe. Yeah, that was not good. This guy though is far too. Oh no! Him being in the corner fucked him right there. That sucks. I think he might have been able to. No, probably not. Well, he had Spark Bolt, didn't he? I think that was a bit too much health left for him to have gotten a full kill off of that. But it's possible. I don't know. Free 2-seek. You saw him start to try and go for it right there, but unfortunately he waited a bit too late. Interesting. So you can roll. At least you can roll catch Tager. It was a gigantic hurtbox. Every single time he's made such a beautiful decision that he's fucked up the actual reward for it. Does he have active flow? He is. Chari's dead. Nope, never mind. Tager has more health than I gave him credit for. Actually, I guess he was basically at half health, right? And he has 12k, I think. Neither one of them. Oh, you're dead. No, but that wasn't the last round. God. I don't know why, this match seems like it's taking a hell of a lot longer. I thought that was the last round. These block streams are good. That's definitely something if I want to actually improve with Tager. My block strings have to get better. They're very autopilot at the moment. Which is terrible for Tager. Like, that's the worst thing you can do with a character like Tager is be predictable. Not out still. Oh, I actually can't believe that didn't work. Well, no, I can. Because there is a small amount of... there's a small amount of invincibility to Atomic Collider. Why do I have that one? Favorited. Did I? Oh, I did record that one. I remember that. God, I'm so far behind these. Taker's Atomic Collider has a very slight amount of invincibility. The problem being that 2C retains a hitbox the entire way down until it hits something, until you either get put in block stun or until it hits you. So the invincibility really doesn't matter. He's still gonna, that hitbox will still exist once the invincibility is gone. Is that not a low anymore? Because it looked like he switched to blocking high, right? He wasn't stuck in block stun the entire time. I don't know. It always surprises me how few Ragnas I see actually go for 6A. Unless they changed it, 6A is a really good anti. Nice low. Fuck. Finish your shit! That's not gonna work now. What are you doing? Oh, yeah, that works. Wait, have I seen this one already? I think we've recorded. I mean, I remember something very, very similar to that happening. And I know it was a Ragna against a Hibiki, but I'm not positive. Fuck it. This is a repeat, I'm sorry. I think this is absolutely a repeat. But now we're too far into it, it doesn't matter. My only problem with Hibiki, he's just, I don't know, there's something about his combos that just rubs me the wrong way. I mean, it's not something, it's not like I can't define it, it's because his combos are always, like, exactly the same. I don't know, something about that is boring to me. Like, the only time it really gets different is in Overdrive, when he has, when you can combo off of all his drive stuff. I do distinctly remember this now. Now that he just did that DP rapid cancel of Gauntlet Hades, I distinctly remember that part. So yeah, we've definitely seen this one before. My bad. You get to watch the gloriousness of it again. Yep, I remember that being very dirty too and surprising me as well. Hopefully that's the only one and I don't have more. I can't imagine I would keep a Hazuma replay longer than I had to. That just feels like something I would never allow to happen. Oh. I think that might be, like, does she literally just, like, lie down to try and hit you? Did I see that animation correctly? That's what it looked like. But it feels like every time I watch an Izanami, they almost always drop that combo route that starts off of her anti-air. I think that's the first time I've ever really seen it come to fruition. Get the entire thing hit. Oh, I don't know if this will kill because of Hazuma's, because of everybody's nerf damage. It should. Definitely looking like it should. It's just kind of... The most experience I've ever had in the BlazBlue game was a continuum shifts. Like, all my frames of references for most of the characters that existed then are what, like, the damage values they were capable of back then, which in general are far higher than they are now. Except the extremes, because obviously there's no overdrive available back then. Holy shit, yeah. That was an incredible amount of blocks to be put in. That was beautiful if that was the intention. It is very possible he reacted to that, but now you're going to eat an additional, what, like 1,500 minimum for a no-tech? That was a good goddamn Hazama. Oh, we're at 30 minutes. Whatever, you'll see one more. As my attempt at repentance from showing you a replay I've already recorded once before. Not bad! It's entirely possible I might have deleted it, but I just accidentally downloaded it twice. Now you got Izzy in overdrive. You are what? Should be. Never mind. There's no kill mix there. Yeah, there really wasn't much mix. I mean, yeah, the teleports were there, but yeah. This Izzy is not really abusing Izzy. I feel like a lot of people just kind of see teleports and are like, oh my god, teleports are so dirty. But Izzy's are actually pretty slow. They're definitely reactable. Even online, they're reactable. It's when you combine it with her bullshit projectiles, when she's in that mode, that they get stupid like that. But it's that stuff, it's her movement, that makes her as dumb as she is. I didn't know she could confirm off of that in that mode. How stupid. Oh, shit. Oops, my bad. We'll just start a new one.